Tá bem, pá. Tá, deixa ele, tá bom? Deixa ele, abre o teu vídeo, tá bom? Deixa ele, abre o teu vídeo, tá bom? Tá aqui, chuva, né? A gente não tem nada a ver, a gente tá chuva, né? Ah, chuva, sim, né? Chuva, tá bom, 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 저 시단인데 아니 전주 남자들이 쉬 쉬디스 와 아니 지금 잡아 아니 저기 해봐 상매스 와 아니 아주 오래 깨워던 데 주제 남대하게 아니 담배 쳐도 되겠지 담배 담배 담화 나네 와 담화 딱지난 담화네야 무구여로 담화 무구여로 들래 이네 전주 기울선 게 남들이 거네 남녀는 문제 때문에 아니 쇼래 되게 아 전주 남기는 바티 아니 자비 키고 로와 삼제기 아니 제와된 데 두자 야 아니 에 대한테 담배 쳐지 아니 기우스 좀 남기는 그래서 그다 근데 일단 기우스 좀 남기는 데 보내 두제 아니 가서 두제 치면 돼야지 치면 되면 돼야 아니 델라야 아니 이라도 좀 와. 델라야 이미 마진이지. 아니 남주는 내가 수시 옆으로 말했어. 이제 남주는 내가 가서지 있나? 좋아. 남주는 내가 가서지 있나? 아니 요즘 내 남주는 내 거네. 아니 남주는 이제 델라야 이라도 좀 좋아. 좋아. 이라도 좋아. 아니 델라야 아니 좀도 예쁘게 좀 그랬어. 제가 굉장히 예좀
Hello, my name is teachings. We spoke about first speaks about the gradual stages to the path of enlightenment according to the different capacities. So we spoke, in the eighth verse we spoke about the greatness of the teachings, and the greatness is summarized in the ninth verse, which allows the individual to know that all the teachings are devoid of having so the Lamrim tradition allows to understand that all the teachings of the Buddha are in like instructions to understand the greatness of the Buddha, to understand the meaning of the Buddha easily. And the fourth one refers to the practitioner to avoid any negative actions. So therefore, the next verse, which summarizes it, saying that therefore this means a sound instruction that is sought after by numerous fortunate ones, like the learned ones of India and Tibet. This instruction of the stages of the path of persons of the three capacities, what intelligent person is there whose mind is not captured by it? לא תלך שבי אחריה. אז אם אכן יש שונה בראשנו, So if we are intelligent people, this kind of fortunate beings who have the access to the text which summarizes all the instructions that the Buddha gave, and practices these instructions, not only understand but also practice engaging them. So an intelligent person
this precise instruction is the essence of all scriptures.
Even though reciting it or listening to it only once, the benefits of teaching the Dharma, listening to it in soul, since such weight of merit bound to be gathered, contemplated meaning. Then this is the 10th verse, and then in the 9th verse it says, what intelligent person is there whose mind is not captured by it? So that's the end of that. So what kind of intelligent person there would not be captivated by these instructions? These instructions, which are common to the three capacity sentient beings, they're common to the lower capacity being, to the middling capacity being, and to the great capacity being. The worms with a great capacity common to the great capacity beings who go on the path to enlightenment means that they've got a common capacity with those who practice mantra or tantra. So it's common with the causal vehicle and the resultant vehicle, like the federal vehicle.
So,
text which refers to an intelligent person, that it doesn't refer to someone who has got a kind of a worldly intelligence or world who is like just a clever or cunning. So it's not someone who's intelligent who can do business, but rather someone who... So what do we mean by someone who is intelligent? Someone who, among this and future life, is someone who focuses more on the future life, on the result of the future life, because the future life is more important than this life. And it is not only that, but also someone who sees the three different sufferings, the three sufferings and the three realms of samsara. Someone who can contemplate about the three sufferings, in particular the pervasive suffering, the third kind of suffering. The pervasive suffering of conditionality. So someone who acknowledges, who is aware of it, and aspires for liberation and for the complete state of omniscience. So this kind of person wishes to be free of all kinds of sufferings. And so this kind of intelligent person is an intelligent person. Also, someone who wishes to be free from the two obscurations, the cognitive and the afflictive obscurations. It is someone who completely wishes to abandon the disadvantages, all the faults in the mind, and attain all the qualities. So this kind of person we speak about in the ninth verse. So it is not someone who is just intelligent or clever, but a kind of intelligence of someone who wishes to go to the state of a conqueror, the Buddha state. So the gradual stages to enlightenment, their distilled essence. This is what is taught in the Lamrim, to devoid of attachment. So someone who goes on this path is listening to the true Dharma. So this great exposition of the stages of the path. So someone who reads it 10 times, well, each time will find 10 different meanings. And someone who reads it 100 times, in each one of these 100 times, will find 100 different meanings. So therefore, just learning or studying even once, the Lamrim has got great benefit.
Lamdun Shinya Tapa Deva, Samdan Ju, Jushin Deva, Tony Sovich Chia, Midoma, Gashin Ju, Chubi Yuachi, Jujuna, and Yamet, and then the Tandu Daya, Jinjan Pelos. Oh, then it, Paju, that Digo Tatoma, Lamdi Dawa Shinya de Juice, Lamdi Dawa Shinya de Juice. That, and there, that you get a new Lamdi Jumba tea. I need to get the Lamzu, need to get Lamzu Lango in 지뎅이 되는 비게 자샤 그래지네 이게 지금 맞된 바래야 타친듯이 챘듯이 요 말로 왔어 요 왔어 제가 되게 인류다네 아 가슈래 아 타바든 탐지에 캠베 썰어 그래야게 아니 남친지 말로 왔지 아니 가슈래 소수 유도리야 가슈래 그게 냠소나야 남자들 마세베 아니 지 그게 에 아니 람 유리 깨바 채발라야 람아지라 마테 바다 아니 에 예버트 땡고 그와 시다디 인도타니 에 센디다 제 치메 아니 지 그게 해서 타다 주네 아니 에 유신이 그와 신이 통 시댄지 로마 신이 통 지 로마 신이 통 시댄지 그와 아니 에 제주람지라 주고 But then it's about how this service can say, and when I show a shilly tirano, Tash, call a name of the king, we call a church of a high man about
the verses 11 and 12. Then the root of creating worthy, auspicious conditions for all excellences of this future world is to rely properly with effort, both in thought and action, upon the sublime spiritual mentor who reveals the path. Seeing this, we should never forsake him even at the cost of life and please him with the offering of implementing his words. I, Ayogi, have practiced in this manner. You who aspire for liberation too should do likewise. So we have spoken about the preliminary thoughts to the text, and now we are entering into the actual paths, actual stages of walking on the path, and these relate to how to rely on a spiritual teacher. So the root of the path is relying on a virtuous spiritual friend or spiritual master. This is because we want to go along the path to enlightenment. We need to know how to do this. Similarly, if we want to do some kind of if we want to learn something as a profession, like a carpentry, we will have to rely on a lama, otherwise, on a teacher, sorry, otherwise it is impossible. So, in the same way, we wish to attain liberation or enlightenment, and therefore we need to go on a true and a correct path. So, and we want to arise the path in our mind. So, therefore, we have to rely on a lama, and a lama is the source of all excellences. In this and in future life. So we need to know the qualifications of a good disciple, and we also need to know the qualifications of a lama.
Senior to us, you were Nishu, and then half a twenty pound shoe. Then you rattle to the market, seven and four from a ten so on a shinky, and you then should do this for the chalice. That Tomata, senior to us,
everyone.
To us, Eddie, that a resident, hurry to us, what is it? Any casual send you to. 对吧？ 신이 유의 신이 신규투와 신규투와 세에 한 가르침 중고였으나 라마 비버는 신규투 탐비인데 토마 신규투와는 랑 신규투가 집고에서 송하는 신기 라마다 니티안이 그게 지금 가시고에다 수진다 대마 对吧? 라마다 니 예주기 마을이 마구와 어다 드리지 그거는 괜찮은 책고에서 신규투와 Niwashi was the Zane, and it do a study to a teacher's hot chair. That she need to watch. Niwashi was the Zane, and it lava dingers in the lave, Yamlin, the one. She was the Zane Chingu, she was. Chingu, she be a dingers in Tembe, and then a temba. She was.
So,
we need to rely on a Lama who's got the defining characteristics of a Lama, and in particular, here we're training in the Mahayana, in the Great Vehicle, and if we rely on someone who does not have the qualifications of a spiritual master, it is not necessary, he will not necessarily lead us on a path which isn't mistaken. So therefore, we need to rely on a teacher who has got all the defining characteristics of a spiritual teacher. This kind of spiritual teacher has got the defining qualities according to the tradition which we practice. So it could be a teacher who will teach us the Vinaya from the Vinaya tradition. This particular teacher needs to have the defining characteristics of the Vinaya, and a teacher who teaches us the secret mantra has to have the defining characteristics of the secret mantra from the Mahayana. A teacher who teaches us the Mahayana vehicle has got to have a particular defining characteristics. So now we're talking about the 10 qualities of a fully qualified spiritual teacher, which are to be disciplined, serene, pacified, having surpassing qualities, wealth of scripture, thorough realization of thusness, that he's energetic, he's the Lord of love, skillful in teachings, and abandoned dispiritedness. So the first one is to be disciplined, and this refers to a teacher who is disciplined, who has tamed his own mind. So this refers to having the complete training of morality, of ethical discipline. And the other quality which the teacher should have is to be serene, and this is cultivated through the perfection of concentration. So this is attained by laxity and excitement, being serene means that the teacher has perfected the training of concentration. And the third quality which the teacher should have is to be pacified. And this to be pacified refers to having a perfection of the training in wisdom. So in this way, the three qualities of the teacher, the first three qualities of being disciplined, serene, and pacified, are referring to having perfected the three trainings.
בואו נחשוב, אני אחשוב לאחר השיעור הזה על מילה אולי טובה יותר, אבל ההבדל הוא שבתכונה השנייה אנחנו מדברים במילים של סירים, בתכונה השלישית זה pacified, אז סירים שקט, אוקיי, אז בואו נקרא לשני, שקט, זה אומר שמשהו שקט הוא רפיון נפש, או רפיון מנטלי, סליחה, זה התרגשות, והשלווה שמושגת על ידי התכונה השלישית, היא שלווה שמפותחת על ידי האימון בחוכמה, שהוא האימון השלישי.
לא עושים את זה, אתם עושים את זה, לא?
לא.
לא עושים את זה, שיהיה תורה שלו, אני עושה את זה. אני יודע לך, לא? ידד, ואני נראה שווה, לוגיץ' לוגיץ' הוא זה, לוגיץ' הוא זה, זה תנת, דמיוסון לא סובה, לא? אני לוגיץ' הוא דבר, לא? תני, זה לא תומס, תני זה נה, תומני, תומני, תומם, תומני לניה, אני כואי יהיה דבר, לא? יג'ו זה מי כואי יהיה דבר, תומני תומי לניה, תומני לניה, תקפיה לי,
So then the fourth quality which the teacher should have is to have a wealth of scripture. Is to have a surpassing knowledge. She spoke about the wealth of scripture, and this refers to the three baskets, the three pitakas. So the teacher should have a wealth of scripture regarding the three baskets, the three pitakas. And then the next quality, the sixth one, is to have a thorough realization of thusness. So the thusness being emptiness. So it is needed that the teacher will have the realization of emptiness, or only have an understanding of emptiness, which is derived from studying and contemplation of the subject of emptiness.
ולפתח לפחות אמונה ברמה של סברה נכונה לגבי השקפת הריקוד. זאת היא התכונה השישית.
נו, נו, תני, לא דודור עושה, לא?
לא.
אני מכיר לזה, לא? לא. דוזיה כמה, סמבה לזה. זו אתה? תשוב, תגיע, דניו סון עושה, אני צריך תגיע, דוזיה נהל, סמבה. אני, מלא, לא משובה, תני לו. מה? לא,
ちゅんちゃん。あ、もちゅんちゃん。で、どんまで。うん。お、さんごてるわ。今日は塩。庭塩。え、で、パパ。あ、ロマで、ロマで、で、パパ、これは。ロマで、ロマで、で、パパ、メイね。あ、で、ロマ。いや、ロマの茶とか、でもね、たまらに牛、これは。で、それでロマで、ロマで、で、パパ。うん、ちょっと。あ、で、え、
이들하고
So then the fourth quality, we're going back to the fourth quality which the spiritual master should have is to have surpassing qualities. So this refers to having surpassing qualities, but the Lama having surpassing qualities of the disciple. Because the Lama needs to deal with the mind stream of the disciple, if the teacher hasn't subdued their own mind, then he cannot be of benefit to the disciple. And therefore, he should have surpassing qualities than the disciple. Even if he has surpassing qualities, if he will not know the scriptures, he will not be able to teach the disciples. So therefore, he should be skillful in teaching, which is another one of the qualities of the spiritual teacher. He should know how to explain the teachings in a way which will benefit him. And he also should be driven from love and care. He should be a lord of love, which is another quality. So even if he will have good qualities, if he will be skillful in teaching, if he will not have love, the disciple will not want to rely on him, and he will not want to teach. So therefore, love is another quality of the teacher. So then another quality which the spiritual teacher should have is to have abandoned dispiritedness. So this refers to being patient, and that means to not be tired, to not be weary of teaching and explaining again and again. So this refers to a lama being patient to explain time and again things that were already explained, because also if the teacher has got surpassing qualities, if he is very learned, if he is skillful in teaching, and even if he is loving, if he hasn't abandoned dispiritedness, this is like an obstacle. So if the Lama gives up on the disciple, then they will not be of much benefit. So therefore, the Lama should have patience and to have abandoned dispiritedness. So we have spoken in general about these 10 qualifications which a teacher should have, but then if one would ask, do all these 10 qualities need to be complete, or are there any other qualities which the teacher should have? So the answer is no. Now, among these 10 qualities, the ones which are the foundation are the three trainings: the training of morality, concentration, and wisdom. These are the main ones. These are in the qualifications there spoken about as disciplined. The teacher should be disciplined, serene, and pacified. So all the other qualities, which are wealth of scripture, thorough realization, etc., they're secondary.
Lama
So in the last two lines of verse 11, it says, is to rely properly with effort, both in thought and action, upon the sublime spiritual mentor who reveals the path. So here the emphasis is on relying properly with effort, both in thought and action. So there are two ways to rely on a spiritual teacher, and one is with relying in thought, and the other one is relying in practice. So by relying in these two ways, we should never let go of the Lama, and this is by actualizing his requests, his teachings. And this is, so when we rely on a teacher, we do it through thought and through action. So when we do it through thought, then we're doing it by considering the kindness of the teacher. So when we consider the kindness of the teacher, we consider him as kind and respecting him because he has led us out of the three lower realms of cyclic existence. And he is also the one who leads us to liberation and enlightenment. So the teacher teaches us what we should practice in an unmistaken way. So it is only the Lama who teaches us not to be born in the three miserable realms which have much suffering, and it is only the Lama who teaches us to attain complete liberation and enlightenment. So by remembering the kindness of the Lama, this is what referring to relying in thought on the Lama, and then to not letting go, not to abandon him, even at the cost of our life, as it says later on in verse number 12. So this is how we rely on the Lama through thought. And the second way of relying on the Lama is by relying him on through the practice. And here there are a few ways that which we should rely on the practice through practice, but the main one is practicing accordance with his instructions, the instructions of our spiritual master. And this refers to practicing in accordance, practicing the Dharma. These are the instructions.
Any
אז השורה השנייה, כמו שאמרנו, אומרת, בבית מספר 12, אומרת, זה לגרום לנחת
אמצעות את השעת המנחה שיש סופר. למה צורכה פה אומר על עצמו, מספר על עצמו, אני היוגי שתדעתי באופן הזה, גם לכם אמצעים לזכות לעשות כך. אז היוגי, למה צורכה, תדעת באופן הזה, תוך כדי סמכות על המורה שלו, נראה, בין שמה שתראה שהוא צורכה מתייחס לדרך שבה הוא הסתמך על המורה הרוח שלו, שג'סון נדאו. So also us who aspire enlightenment should practice in this way. So the main...
ཁྱི དང མ དུན པའི 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 ཁྱི དང མ ད ושוד תמבינה ניבט טוגורס יאן די קיימבי שוד מאזוב דזן סונגוס נאמאלי ניימוי צבאט מאזוב צבאט דזאמני צשונדס
הסתמכות על מורה הרוח הוא משהו שמאוד חשוב לנו.
Relying on the teacher, on the spiritual master, is something which is very important. Is the Lama is the one who teaches us what we should practice. So, therefore, we practice his instructions exactly as he teaches them. But then, should we rely on a teacher without thinking? Should we do everything which he tells us? So, the answer is no. If what the teacher teaches us is not concordant with the Dharma, then it is something that we should not do. Instead of that, we should approach the teacher and tell him, tell the spiritual teacher that this instruction is discordant with the Dharma and therefore we cannot accomplish it. And also if it is something which is concordant with the spirit of the Dharma, but it is something which is not in our ability, then we should explain to the teacher, say sorry, and say that we cannot do it, cannot actualize it right now. But if we do not tell the Lama directly, and instead of that we find faults and speak against him, then this is something that we should never do. We should never despise him and speak against him. So relying on the teacher is by fulfilling his instructions properly, with instructions which are in the spirit of the Dharma.
אז אנחנו לא חייבים ביישם את ההוראות האלה.
If you want to study this subject in a vast way, then you can read the great exposition to the stages of the path.
たまんじで頼むのに、次々。では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では、では חשוב לשינגי, צוות ציפול בטני, חשוב לשורט כמעט פרידי ליזיתני, אז סוף לסופר ציגיון שמעת אותה. תאנה שינגי ציפיגי, היה תמיה כמיה, what they have been equally what then yoy does as we know it that loosen it as we do in the trees here the pasha the one ali the head near the pasha the one so 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 in the because of the name 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 あれ、で、え、そうだ。私、で、で、どんねりなっちゃうわ。で、でもいいもん。あの、で、そのの。ただ、かしゅうれ。でもいいもん。ただ、で、じゃあ、で、さんぼせ。と、で、で、さんぼと。あれ、とばつのまんせべてね、で、かしゅうんじゃがわ。で、え、さんじにでもだっちゃ。あれ、ちゃがわ、あんまのまって、てもちびきびしに。しに。ちゃ。
내내비게
ね、見てね、実装でやるです。で、なんていうかね、あの、あの、可愛くて、なんていうんで、あれ、可愛かったです。じゃあ、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、で、 치투 유자티 유자네 아 저리스 보아봐 근데 내리네 그래 내리자 봐봐 이시 누구를 무슨 봐봐 아니 이시 누구를 무슨 생기한기 이게 기부 저번 때 저도 맞아 지금 근데 저러지 어떻게 해 말한 줄이 내 상황이 세디가 파시한 지대 치면 굉장히 이게 내 상황이 좀 하시고 이게 좀 투여 누가든데 막 이제 일단은 다시 시작이 다시 시작이 어차피 나한테 하고 같이 그렇게 진짜 못했어 아니야 또
So then
in verses 13 and 14 read, this life of leisure is even more precious than I wish one to endure, that I have found such an existence is only this world, so hard to find, yet like a flash of lightning, it is easy to vanish. Contemplating this situation, it's vital to realize that all mundane pursuits are like the empty grain husks of floating in the winds, and that we must extract the essence of human existence. I, a yogi, have practiced in this manner. You will aspire for liberation, too should do likewise. So these two refer to the leisures and opportunities or the freedoms, the freedoms of a human state. So these freedoms are more precious than a wish fulfilling jewel. This word freedom is actually a leisure. It is a leisure to practice the Dharma. So we're free of a state of not having the freedom, of not having the leisure. We're free of the state of not having the three lower realms, the realms of being hell beings and being pretas or hungry ghosts. Being in the state of an animal, so being in the animal realm. If we were born into one of these three lower realms, into the three miserable states, then we would not be able to practice the Dharma. So we would have, not only would we not be able to practice the Dharma, we would have a constant risk for our life. We would be mostly concerned with food, with drink, with clothing. So these are difficulties which we would encounter. So if we were born into these three lower realms of hell being, hungry ghosts and animals, of course we would not be able to practice the Dharma, or how difficult it would be to find food, drink and clothing. But the greatest difficulty would be to just remain alive. So someone who would be born into these three lower states, it would be a very saddening and unbearable suffering. The beings who are born into the hell realm, they experience hot and cold suffering. The ones who are born into pratis experience hunger and thirst. And the ones who are born as animals, they have the ignorance, stupidity. This is the suffering which is characterized in the animal realm. So if we acknowledge the opportunity, the good situation which we have of being human beings, so not only have we got this good human body, but also we have met the Dharma, and we met a good spiritual teacher who has got all the characteristics. We have all good conditions, conducive conditions to practice the Dharma. So we meet different spiritual teachers, and if we actualize the instructions which they give us, if it's on the highest level, we would attain enlightenment. If we practice on a middling level, we'd attain liberation. And on the lowest level, at least we would get a higher, we would attain a higher realm. So these are in the good states. So this is again by having the good conditions to practice the Dharma. So as this 13th verse says, basis of a human being body is greater than a wish fulfilling jewel. So it says that previously in the world there was a wish fulfilling jewel that would accomplish any wish which we wanted, which would be which would have the ability to accomplish the current life's wishes, like food, clothing and house. So this human body has got a greater power than a wish fulfilling jewel, because the wish fulfilling jewel can attain goodness for the future lives. We can practice practices which we would get good benefits for the future lives. So therefore this human body has got a great potency which is more than a wish fulfilling jewel. So it's very important to contemplate like that.
Yet in me, you almost on the damn, I don't know.
So when we recognize the current human body which we have, which has got its freedoms and also opportunities, so there are 8 freedoms and 10 opportunities. We have the freedoms. We have a state which is free of not having the freedoms or the leisures, and we also have the 10 opportunities. So these eight freedoms are the freedom of not being a hell being, the freedom of not being a preta, a freedom of not being an animal, and a freedom of not being a long-lived god. We have the freedom of not being in a state that there is no conqueror's word, being the there is no Buddha's teaching, and also we are people who live in do not live in a borders region, so we're not in a like barbarian. We do not have wrong views, which means that we believe in the Dharma. And the last one is that we are not mute and we have all our sense faculties complete. So these are the eight freedoms which we have as human beings with all these qualities of leisure's complete.
יש לנו את החירות מהמצב הזה שבו אנחנו היינו נולדים במקום שהוא לא מטורבל, באזור שהוא אזור גבול. מעבר לזה גם אנחנו, אין לנו איזשהו גם פיזי שמונע מאיתנו ללמוד ולתרגל את הדרמה. באופן מאוד מצומצם זה מתייחס לעובדה הזאת שאנחנו לא נולדנו לא נולדנו חרשים, או לא נולדנו עם איזושהי בעיה מנטלית או בעיה אחרת שהייתה מונעת מאיתנו ללמוד ולתרגל את הדרמה. זה אומר שיש לנו את כל החושים, יש לנו את כל היכולות שמאפשרות לנו ללמוד ולתרגל את הדרמה, ולכן יש לנו גם חירות פה. מעבר לזה אנחנו גם, יש לנו חירות מהשקפות שהן השקפות שגויות. אם תהיה לנו השקפות שהן שגויות, לדוגמה, כאלה שטוענות באי קיום של קרמה וכו', לא תהיה לנו גם את החירות בתרגול של הדרמה. כדי להשלים את האוסף של שמונה חירויות, האחרונה היא להיוולד במקום ובזמן שבו השיעורים של הבודה אינם קיימים. מאחר ויש לנו את החירות הזאת במצב שבו השיעורים של הבודה לא יהיו קיימים, אז אנחנו משלימים את האוסף של שמונה חירויות.
So then the next thing which we're endowed with beyond the eight freedoms are the 10 opportunities. So the 10 opportunities are divided into two categories. The first one are opportunities which are pertaining to oneself, and the other ones are opportunities which are pertaining to others. The ones who are pertaining with oneself refer to the opportunities which are related in dependence on myself, and the other ones which are, we have them in dependence on others.
Ramjong
산지 계획과 팀원을 만나게 되고 있죠. 아니 대리 대지에서 중요해요. 와. 산지에 산지에 된다. 산지에 된다. 주대. 대바 계획 대바 민영 봐. 내가 같이 와. 네. 아니 가시오래 콜 아니 가시오래 출주해야지 다 좋았으면 좋겠어 아니 더 아니 자원을 대봐 유대 어디 굉장히 저녁 하는 시험이 됐어
So His Eminence just wants to make clear, to make sure that we have the list clearly. So there are the eight freedoms, which the first ones are freedom from being in the lower realms, of being a hell being, being a preta, being a hungry ghost or an animal. So these are the first three. The other one is having a freedom of being a non-human, which here refers to a long-lived god. And the next one is being in a state where there's no conqueror's teaching, the Buddha's teaching. And the next one is being a person who is born in a borders region. And the next one is having one views. And to complete list is having is being freedom having the freedom of not having complete faculty so referring to having all the ability to speak and all our sense faculties complete so on top of that we have 10 opportunities and these opportunities again are divided into two groups one group is opportunities which are pertaining to oneself while the other ones are opportunities which are pertaining to others. The opportunities which are referring to oneself, concerned with oneself, are being a human being. That's the first one. The second one is being born in a central region. The third one is having complete sensory faculties. The fourth one is having reversible karma which we did not create any extreme actions in. And the fifth one is having faith in the source, meaning having faith in the Dharma, the three baskets. So then the opportunities which are pertaining with others are the fact that the Buddha has come to this world and the sublime teachings were taught. He taught the Dharma. The third one is that the teachings which the Buddha gave, they still remain in the world. And the fourth one is that those who follow the Dharma, there's the Sangha, who are like friends to us on the path. And the last one, that there is love and care in the world. Okay, so again, the opportunities, the 10 opportunities which we have are opportunities which are pertaining with oneself. And these are to be a human being, to be born in a central region, to have complete sensory factors, to have reversible karma, and to have faith in the source. So, and the opportunities which pertain with others are the fact that the Buddha has come, that the sublime teachings, the sublime teaching were taught, and that the teachings remain, and those who follow the teachings, and the last of the opportunities which pertain with others is that there is love and care in the world.
האחרונה היא שיש לנו אמונה במקור, זה אומר שיש לנו, יש לנו אמונה במקור של השיעורים של הבודה.
So, we have this good human life, we have this good human basis, and we have met a precious spiritual master. We have attained these eight freedoms, and the eight freedoms and the ten opportunities. So we should, it is very important, because of this, it is very important to practice the Dharma properly, because we have attained these independence on many causes and conditions from a previous life. It is very difficult to have to attain these causes and conditions for attaining this precious human life, because these causes and conditions first depend on having good morality. This is the basis. The basis for getting this human life is by keeping good morality, and on top of that, that which assists this basis is the practice of the six perfections, and that which completes it all is the aspirations for pure aspirations to get the human life. So because it is so difficult to get all these three different conditions of the basis of good morality, the assisting cause, which is doing the six perfection, and the last one of having the aspirations, the pure aspirations. So therefore, in this way, we can see how difficult it is to collect all the causes and conditions to have a complete, a perfect human birth.
Then I'm чиг тогоцтой мөгүчтэй ишүү лугбатаг таны шинж тэгээд гоо мөгүчтэй баруун чэдэг санди үчдэг эсэл бүгдээр баа. Тэгвэл рэди ине санди үчдэг. Хатэм мөгүч үжио. Чэнгээ тэгээд ажиллаж. Моноч чонго самжаач. Тэгвэл чиг гангалоо гэмэр чийсэн чиг. Ни жүрүү чиг. Мэзэн апангайд үстэй чэ. Анита таблом шимамани чүсэн гэж юу чаг고 아이디나 넘버 나버산지 비추스 제 지금 어디 중지 드리 무도 강내로 체제로 근데 강내 체제고 겐 체제고 겐이 호스 차려 겐이 도샤 저는 이 물론 좋은 참제였다 그냥 참고
So, first of all, that this precious human breath which we have has got the eight freedoms and the ten opportunities, and it is not that we have attained them without causes and conditions. We didn't get them just without any reason. So this good basis is necessarily, definitely dependent on many causes and conditions which we have cultivated in previous lives. So, of course, we will think about other situations like in this world which we live in, there's so many people. Does it mean that everybody has got this good basis of leisures and opportunities, of freedoms and opportunities? So, because there's so many people in the world, first of all, it proves that the fact that they've got this human life is because they have practiced morality previously. Otherwise, without keeping morality, one would not get a human body. So we can know certainly that in their previous life they have practiced morality. So when we have a human body with this basis, morality has to be kept purely. We have to have the six perfections, the practice of the six perfections as an aiding condition. And they, and lastly, we attain it with pure aspirations or prayers. So we need all these causes and conditions to get this good basis. Not all beings in the world have got this pure basis, this good basis. They have a human body, but not all of these freedoms and opportunities are complete. Look at how many Dharma practitioners there are in the world. There's so many human beings, but among them, how many are really a real Dharma practitioner? And among the many of them do not practice any religion at all. So among the ones who practice religion, how many are the ones who practice the Bodhidharma? And then among the ones who practice the Bodhidharma, how many of them practice the Hinayana or the Mahayana, the greater vehicle and the foundation vehicle? And how many of them rely on a virtuous spiritual friend? These are very few. And the ones who practice Tantra are even fewer. So perhaps we can practice, just to illustrate it, we can count the ones who have got all the conducive conditions to practice the Dharma can be counted on one hand. It is so, in this way, it is so difficult to get the complete set of freedoms and opportunities. Think how difficult it would be if we didn't have enough food and drink and clothing, if we had didn't have conditions to, of course, we would not be able to practice and study the Dharma. So all these leisures and opportunities are dependent on conditions, causes and conditions which we got in our previous life. Think of the situation in the world. how many Christian countries there are, how many people there are in the world who have never met the Dharma. So we have been born in a country where Buddhism is not part of our culture. But nevertheless, we got the opportunity to meet the Dharma, and this proves that it is because we have perfected our prayers. So why do people meet the Dharma? It is because they have met some difficulties in their life, and because of that, they have found the Dharma, they have turned to the Dharma. So when you look at it in this way, meeting, having the difficulties is actually a good thing. So by keeping morality, by practicing the six perfections and making the complete prayers, all this is what brings us towards finding the Dharma. So they do not happen without causes and conditions, but rather a way that we have collected the causes in the past. So let's leave it at that. Do you have any questions? So there are a few questions here. Actually, I think what I will do, I will translate it to Rinpoche in English. And I hope that through my translation to English you will all understand. And if not, please raise your hand and I'll explain and I'll translate.
Okay. So the question is, first of all, there are many different kinds of texts. For example, when Kyabjin Rinpoche organized the Chanchun Bangrin teachings, there were 18 different texts that were taught. So the first question is, why do we have so many Bangrin texts? What is the significance of each and every one of them, in the sense that could Rinpoche say that, for example, such and such Bangrin text, for example, you know, this is something that I had to see this question. If, for example, Lama Tsongkhapa composed the three extents of the says of the Path and Mahan, do they have any significance that is different to other Lamrim texts? So that's the second question. The third question is, as Kelchen Rinpoche requested his owners or organized the Janchu Lamrim teaching, what was the motive or the reason for that Rinpoche requested his owners to do it? In a sense of what is the great significance of teaching 18 different texts of the Lamrim? And then the last question is, could you please give us a practical advice on, there's such a great wealth of the Lamrim traditions, you know, massive wealth of the Lamrim tradition. Could you please give us a practical advice on how to put it into practice? So the first one was, why is it that there are so many different Lamrim texts?
Why are there so many different Lamrim texts? And among the different Lamrim texts, is it that some of them have some significance or some highlights, whereas others have different highlights or different significance? Or is there a difference between the different Lamrim texts? So no, there's no difference. The subject matter is the three different capacities of sentient beings. So the great exposition of the Lamrim was written by Tsongkhapa.
רואה? אני קשור זה לא מסדר, זה לא מסדר, רואה? עוד את נראה לי, למה אני ככה במושי ושי דה קשה צנג'י שעדי עודי קשה צנג'י שעדי ועודי קשה ינצ'י כפי תג'י כשו רוצי, עוד עוד שום מולפתח הנה דה תגן אני יחשו רואה מונה פשוט שום עודי, למה אני צנג'י שום סונדי דה צוץ שישו מהם זה דייר תגן יחוד דה אני תהי שואל היה שם בתגן da tu na ja ušta čego. I možu ne to, ti se rumo se sumo na da da. I pedo čišu da. I čelo čišu da, mi va čišu. I on je to. Ti je je nije.
Nije vai ti, ani
So the second question is, Rinpoche asked His Holiness the Dalai Lama to teach 18 different Lamrim texts. So why did you see it so important to teach 18 different texts of the Dalai Lama?
18 the Maya, 18 the Maya,
And then the last question was saying
that there is such a wealth of Lamrim texts.
It's so massive. So
if His Eminence Ling Rinpoche could give us advice about how to put it into practice, practical advice of practice.
So why are there so many texts
which teach the gradual stages to enlightenment? Why are there so many texts of the Lamrim? So first His Eminence said that there is no substantial difference between these texts. They all teach the same thing. So the gradual stages of enlightenment, they teach the gradual stages of enlightenment of the three different capacity beings. So So it's not that there are only 18 texts, but there are actually more than 18. But the main ones, according to his eminence, are the great, the middling, and the concise stages, exposition of the stages to the path, which were composed by Rinpoche Tsongkhapa. So there are other texts which are also composed by others, like Shama Lamrim and Liberation in the Path of Your Hand. So, all these different texts, which are like the swift path to enlightenment, or the easy path to enlightenment. So there are different names of texts, which and others, composers like Lama Tsongkhapa and others have written. So some texts don't quite deal with the meaning of the words, but rather of the essence of the teachings to enlightenment. So because there are different texts that put an emphasis on different aspects, there is a great abundance of the stages, texts which deal with the gradual stages to enlightenment, and the best ones, according to his eminence, of Lama Tsongkhapa's text. So, when we study this, we can study the kind of variety of the Lamrim texts which have the blessings of the lineage of the different teachers to the stages, to actualize the stages to enlightenment. So then the second question was, since how many texts are there? So there are much more than 18 texts, and the question was, why did His Eminence Ling Rinpoche ask His Holiness the Dalai Lama to teach these 18 texts? So there are many long texts and short texts which explain the stages to enlightenment. So His Eminence said that first he actually asked His Holiness to teach only 8 texts. Despite that, His Holiness decided to add another 10 texts. For example, the Liberation in the Path of Your Hand of Pabongka Rinpoche, and the Shamar Lamrim, which are also Lamrim texts. So these were part of the... So also the three principal aspects of the path, and the foundation of all good qualities were also texts which were taught by His Holiness Dalai Lama. So why did His Eminence ask these texts? The answer for that is because His Eminence in his previous life, the sixth Ling Rinpoche, was the tutor, the senior tutor of His Holiness the Dalai Lama, and he's the one who taught him the Lamrim Chenmu, the great exposition of the stages of the path. And Ling Rinpoche, in his previous life, he studied these meditations from the 13th Dalai Lama. So because there's a connection between the lineage of Ling Rinpoche and His Holiness the Dalai Lama, they taught each other these texts. That's why Ling Rinpoche asked His Holiness the Dalai Lama to learn the Lamrim, to give the teachings of the Lamrim. That is the reason. And then talking about what is the practical advice to practice this kind of vast teachings, that is the bodhicitta, His Eminence says, the mind to practice the mind of enlightenment, to arise the mind of enlightenment in our mind. Bodhicitta has got the greatest power, it has got the greatest potential, not only for ourselves, but for others. It has got a true altruism, and this bodhicitta is a very precious thing. So this is the most important thing. Of course, there are other teachings that in the Lamrim, which they're all aimed in arising the mind of enlightenment in our mind, this bodhicitta. And these are the contemplations about this precious human life, impermanence and death. So through impermanence and death, we think how we need to, at the moment, to practice the Dharma, because we can lose our life at any point. So also we contemplate about the lower realms. So when we contemplate, why do we contemplate about all these different stages? They're all meant to arise. Bodhicitta, the mind of enlightenment in our mind, and if we arise it, we can definitely bring benefit to others.